I'm rolling again and again. I'm in the butt, I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30. You in the butt, you in the butt. Either you run it or roll in the dust. You win it, so what? No, no, they're just for gaming. They're good. They're pretty sleek, right?
Yeah.
I don't think Xbox like, came out with one of these when they came out.
Like, hey,
hold on. I gotta make sure the video's on. No game chat, right? You can't hear me? I feel like you can hear me. Am I muted? Hang on one sec. Let me see. I gotta learn where these buttons are. No doubt. Let me see.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a
foe. Connect. Not here. Jim's mom. Sometimes I need a check. Not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step. You change name. How about your respect? Give them more than what I get, expecting up the back. In fact, you know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news. Okay. I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot. Okay. I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more. Okay. Look. Sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of the bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait. Jugging on the main stage. Put the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay. Meditate. Hydrate. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having
nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't wanna seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle, pockets LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I wanna see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that, it's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend their hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line. No lie. Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Denver Broncos and the Detroit Lions.
Bradley Pinion set to kick off.
The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week five on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Staying in his sight line and getting to that same part of the field, and they find each other for the completion.
And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss. Coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and run for it. Boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he shortened the line to gain. The Lions turned away on fourth down. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon.
Destinations all I want to see. Ocean from residences, three different ones a week. Because I deserve that.
is that a line at? Mess around and put that thing over your permit. Six figures every year, yeah.
Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. Now it's Rosen looking, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Throwing on second and 3, Rosen. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
He's brought down.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On third and 1, Rosen. Got a man. It's Judy complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. It'll be a pickup of 4, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
First down, Broncos.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Now Rosen on first down. Pass complete to his receiver, pass. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
Complete.
That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. From the 10, first and goal. It's Rosen. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
At the 4-yard line.
Shotgun to McCaffrey, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver.
Christian McCaffrey.
Touchdown. His 6th touchdown of the season, and the Broncos have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? What he told us?
Yeah, absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Bradley Pinion set to kick off.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Catch signal 4 and taken successfully.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with Colt?
Traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And these guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Bill Charles, that makes now 5 interceptions and not even 5 quarters. Remember, he threw 4 picks last week.
And this turns into a tough situation because a lot of fans, the first thing is, oh, we need to change quarterbacks. This is your guy. This is your elite player. You can't just...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
Touchdown.
Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 of the year. And the Broncos push further out in front. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about? Low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet. He recognized
that. That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take him all to dinner.
Take over first and 10. At their own 23-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Trying to lay one up deep. Oh, bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And he'll take it across midfield and down the 45.
The man's pretty simple, and it's fairly obvious, isn't it? He's got to start making better decisions with the ball.
That's now 2 interceptions in the first quarter. After interception number 1, there was a long talk on the sideline. And now he's made another mistake.
Yeah, he's just been kind of laying these passes out there. He's kind of been floating them a little bit. He's got to be more decisive in his reads and definitely more decisive in throwing the ball. Right in there.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one by the line of scrimmage.
And he's going to be swallowed up. Safe back at the 45-yard line.
9 yards. And maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on 3rd down. To throw is Rosen. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's 4th down.
Now 4th down.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away.
The Lions take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happened. Tackled by Bradley Chubb, the number 5 pick in the 2018 draft.
At the 23-yard line.
Ping, ping, ping.
On 2nd down. Huntley, and he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play.
With the score, Broncos 14, Lions nothing.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They run the option here on 1st and 10. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on 1st down. They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Set up shop at the 33-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
They've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
So how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well, and maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area. That it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On third down, Rosen. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he will bring it back. An interception return for the last touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And that one makes it 14-7.
Makes the score, Broncos 14, Lions 7.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded in the end zone. Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Back to the air, Rosen after the pick six. He's got his big tight end, Fan. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down. That catch good for only a couple.
The 22-yard line.
From the 22, here's second and 8. They'll run with McCaffrey. And some room to run now. And he will finally be wrestled down at the Lions' 23-yard line. A big play there from McCaffrey, 55 yards.
And the Broncos' first down.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now a run with McCaffrey. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20.
I'm wondering, partner, if they might need to sub him out for a play or two, because after that long run he just had on the previous play, he might not have all of his breath back.
Yeah, and they went right back to that well. Different result. And the last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Out of the gun. Here's Josh Rosen. Looking to complete it to Pettis, and he's got him.
Complete.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
The Broncos on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. Down as he gets it to the 8. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a 1st and goal.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Christian McCaffrey on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Broncos will extend their lead. Touchdowns on their first 3 possessions, and they're a PAT from going up 21-7.
Yeah, very impressive the way that they've moved the football. Full command of their playbook, full command of the way they wanted to attack.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership.
Rush coming and he's taken down.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple scoring, Brandon. And guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20.
Hey, alert, 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 alert.
Another try after the first down sack. Mayfield, open target here, Darius Slayton. And down he'll go at the 25. Coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Sideline and talk over what to do next. Here comes the Lions punter now. Back to return it, Christian McCaffrey. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. The Broncos onto the field ready to start their next drive. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action. Now's the time to take a shot. But you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad.
Is that
he would have kissed it on the ground.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From the gun, it's Rosen. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Third down, here's McCaffrey. He's got first down and more inside the 30. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Rosen looking to throw. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And they'll take it into the end zone for the Denver score. Christian McCaffrey on his way to a historic performance. 4 first half touchdowns. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. Mar now to add the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7.
Makes the score Broncos 28, Lions 7. Bradley Pinion set to kick off.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this carries him in the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Get ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little bit, and start over. I don't know if this is the time to push it myself.
Well, right now, under 100 yards of total offense.
27-yard line.
Second and 8 at the 27-yard line. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
To kick off.
Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And they'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Three on the return. The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field ready to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
To throw on first down to Josh Rosen. That's going to be caught by Jody. And here to Crowell across midfield down to the 45. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Here's Rosen to throw. Up to Judy. And they'll wind up getting this with all the way down inside the 20.
27 on the play.
A very solid gain of 27. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. This is McCaffrey. This one down to about the 17.
The ball carrier.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might well go ahead and run it anyway because that's your strength.
Off the play fake. Here's Rosen. Are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the one. Great mix defensive play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the one. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal. Another shot from the one on second and goal. They get this out left, and they'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
Denver.
Jerry Jeudy, his sixth touchdown of the season. Now the Broncos push further out in front. Had the option there, read it perfectly, and an easy little touchdown toss.
And it has to be a sharp throw, too, because of where they are on the field. The extra traffic, things are condensed near the goal line. Good route by the receiver as well.
Bradley Pinion set to kick off.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. And this carries into the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you go over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. A run with Huntley. They're taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
46-yard line.
On first down, Huntley. Inside the 25. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. They've done a pretty good job containing him up until this drive, and until that run, there was no containing him at all.
Yeah, you're right about that. He finally popped free. But we didn't have to be in their practice sessions. We didn't have to be in their meeting rooms. They planned for a run like that to happen, maybe a couple of them. But what did they tell their guys all week? You know what they said. Move on to the next play. That one just happened. Let it go.
On first and 10, it's Smith. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes a defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Once again, it's Smith. 4 yards on the pickup there. Now they're left with a third and 8.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Third and 8.
Made at the 18-yard line. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll bring up fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Now Mayfield on fourth down. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
And his kick is right through.
Makes it. That
is going to do it. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety and being able to hit people with a run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The Lions on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4.
Gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And it's looking all the more likely that a 5th straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a 1st and 10. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down.
1st down, Denver.
Now Rosen. This is the tight end Fan. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on 1st down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a 2nd and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3. Shotgun handoff down to McCaffrey. And he's going to have a Broncos 1st down as good running gets him to about the 44. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the 4th quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. They'll try and burn some clock down in McCaffrey. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
Third down.
The Broncos on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 11. Here's Rosen. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And to the 49-yard line, but no further. And obviously, he is well short of the 1st. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a 4th down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the four-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the five-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that's going to make it 2nd and 14. To throw, Mayfield. That's complete to Slayton. He's out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Catch made by Slayton. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down.
Detroit Lions.
From the gun, Mayfield. And now here's another interception. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
This will make it into the end zone. Decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
20-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Going right side, he finds Slayton. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. They face a 3rd and 4 after that last completion gets him 6. They'll buy some time right. Got a man, Slayton. They get him down the line before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Little OT scramble drill that time, Mr. Davis.
And partner, I can tell you from personal experience, nothing drives a defense crazier than having things covered and the quarterback takes off and picks up a first down or big yardage. Because whether we're in zone or man, it's easy to lose track of him because you don't always have someone assigned to him. And once he goes, now everybody's scrambling to try and tackle him.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.
Accountant, he said, I got good news and I got bad news. Okay. I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot. I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more. Okay, look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of bait. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay, but wait. Jugging on the main stage, the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. Whoa. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I want to see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that. It's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend. Not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see what your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line. No lie.